Hello guys, Yuri really speaking here. So today I would like to make a review of Razer Ferox mobile gaming and music speakers. For you guys out there who want to know what is included in the box, please go ahead to my YouTube channel and watch my unboxing video, or just have to click on the link which I'll put at the bottom right hand side of this video right now. First and foremost, I would like to talk about the physical looks or the design of these speakers. As you can see in front of you now is the speakers itself. At the side, it has a really nice sandpaper texture to it, which can also avoid the fingerprints issue. Besides that, it also has glossy black plastic surface. At the top, it has a speaker's grill. Inside the speaker's grill, you will see a 30mm driver. At the top, it has a Razer logo at the middle with a glossy plastic surface. As for the bottom, it has a Razer Ferox branding, some cord bar, rubber feet for better gripping experience on your desk or table, with blue LED at the side. So the blue LED acting as your battery indicator. As for the back, you will have a mini USB port, which is for your audio or power cable. So how to use it is really simple. Just have to make sure that your R and L facing upwards before plug it in. As simple as that. As for the cable, it is braided, so it can avoid the tangling issues. The design of these two speakers are identical. As for the other end of the cable, you will have a USB connector for charging purposes, and a 3.5mm jack for audio. Besides that, it has a plastic thing at the cable there. So the function of this plastic is to ease the users in cable management. So the next thing I would like to talk about is the mechanism of turning on and off the speakers. In order to turn it on, you just have to press it down and the blue LED will lit up. If you want to turn it off, you just have to press it down again and the blue LED will be off. Now I'd like to talk about the lighting modes. The lighting modes function once the speakers are powered on. Basically, it has two conditions. One, USB plug-in. Second, USB unplug. As you can see in front of you now, it's under USB plug-in. The blue LED keeps blinking, indicates that the battery is charging. When the battery is fully charged, the blue LED will not blinking. Move on to the second condition. When the battery is in use, it has a blue LED. When the battery has less than 10% charge, it has red LED. And when the battery is depleted, it has no LED lights. So that's all for the lighting modes. So now I'd like to talk about the pros and cons of these speakers. Firstly, I would like to talk about the pros. It has 7 pros in total. First, it is very mobile as the size is very small and compact, which only weigh around 210 grams. Second, although the size is quite small, it still produces loud and crisp sounds. Besides that, it produces omnidirectional sounds, and the expanded bass resonance chamber produces quite powerful bass as well. As for the driver, it is 30mm in size. The battery life for these speakers is really good. It can last up to 12 hours of playbacks. The charging duration of these speakers is around 3 hours. You can charge it via the USB port. The built-in battery is very handy as you do not need to bring external batteries with you when you go out. The braided cord will avoid the tangling issues. The good battery life indicators, which is indicated by the lighting modes, I really love it. 7, or last but not least, the included pouch, which is very useful when you want to bring your speakers out. So now I'd like to talk about the cons. There are 3 cons in total. The first one is the interchangeable speakers. I can't really differentiate which one is the right or left speakers after I plug in the audio cable. For you guys' information, the R and L indicators are only imprinted at the mini USB connectors itself. The second cons will be the volume control function. you have to go to your computer to control the volume of the speakers because it does not have a physical volume controller. The third con will be the price. The MSRP for these speakers is around $60, which is quite expensive. You can top up a little bit and get a quite decent 2.1 channel speakers with that amount of money. So that's all for my review. I hope you guys enjoy it. Ultimately, please like, comment, and subscribe.